speaking about optimum capacitance low, to preventing voltage instabilities in electrical distribution lines. Conventional electrical production and, of course, renewable energy, especially solar, in the case of Israel, working, and wind can be used for produce the electrical demands, to cover electrical demands of the industry and of the population, of the civil requirements. So I want to show that the rise of electricity production is previous one. The worldwide increase in renewable electricity production is for wind only, is going up very quickly, sharply, let's say, in exponential rate. And until 2020 expectation for 2025, we can see that electrical production for renewables can get, let's say, 5, 7, even 10% in worldwide electricity production. Depends on the country, of course, some countries maybe less and some countries maybe bigger figure. So the reason for this situation is preventing pollution, as said, safe of environment quality, and the permanent decrease of electricity price, especially in solar PV station. And now we can see that price of cost of electricity is much less, one of the smallest figures inside all sources of electrical production, including coal, nuclear, gas station, and maybe only today combined gas power station can produce electricity with the less cost. So these are the reasons which caused to the widespread of electricity production in the world. In Israel too, this trend began not so many years ago. Instead of other parts, especially Europe, Germany and France, they dealt with the renewables much more years. In Israel it was postponed, really in reality due to the high cost of electricity, solar especially electricity production during previous years. Now, as we saw, electricity drops down, cost of electricity drops down, and it gives the push for producing of product or building new electrical station. We see in the map the places, the biggest places, especially in the south region of Israel, for applicable for this solar production. Here, the first of the stations are not so big, some tens of kilowatts in the kibbutz in near Eilat, south area, south region of Israel, and one of the pioneer stations, solar plants, let's say. And now, this year, begins to work very big thermal solar power station, 250 megawatts, whether it's very big power for one single plant. And this is thermal solar station, began to work and produce electricity. Many advantages we see this widespread of renewable energy, electrical renewable energy. However, as we know, for example, here we can see this rise of the electrical installation in Israel. We can see that until 10 years ago it was nearby close to zero, and now we can see this sharp production. And so we see many advantages of renewable energy, especially solar But as we know, philosophically, all new solutions which solve previous disadvantages produce their own problems as well. And electrical production from solar causes to some new technical problems and challenges. What they are? First, instability of power production as during day house and seasons. We know that at night period of time electricity is not produced by solar station and this of course some of the problems. More difficult problem that there is when the solar production becomes significant. We made the research for Israel condition, it will be 10% of the total energy production. Will begin the problem with frequency control. And the second and the third disadvantages are related to the stochastic characteristics of the solar production. So we know that cloudy days may increase or clouds may decrease significantly, and on the other hand, full solar solar irradiation can cause to the higher production. And for example, during some years measurements, we saw that during 1 second, in the resolution 1 second only, the energy production can be raised and dropped down until 30-35% only 1 second. So in this case, when the electrical production in solar station will be significant, so it will produce problem for the usual steam turbines. And steam turbines cannot be controlled so quickly, and therefore there will be the deviation of the frequency. And this is a very big problem, so it's needed to be prevented. The third problem, as I said, connected to the stochastic characteristic of the solar production, is deviation of voltage in distribution lines and for local consumers. For example, as we will see here, distribution line is a solar station. First of all, in the right side, we see electrical power system equivalent, presented as equivalent scheme. In Israel, it's 161 kilovolts. As usual, there are some lines 400 kilovolts, but widespread ones have 61 kilowatts. So it goes to the substation with the transformers, which transform this voltage to the middle voltage, 33 kilowatts or 22 kilowatts. After this line goes, depends on the area, until 10, even 25 kilometers to the local consumers, and there installed high voltage, middle voltage, low voltage transformers, and as usual, they are located to local PV station. Today is so widespread that many private owners equipped their roofs with PV panels, and many kibbutz produce, create field station for private consumers up to the 10, 20 kilowatts. But for example, kibbutz have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 megawatts of installed power, so it's significant more. And what regarding the voltage distribution? So it is well known that long line, relatively long distribution line, having impedance causes to the different, depends on the consumer current, there are produced voltage drops to prevent voltage instabilities in substation. transformer substation are equipped with so-called tap changers. This is the electromechanical appliance which change the transformation ratio of the transformer, so it can change the transformer ratio in accordance with the current consumer's power, and to prevent the voltage instabilities. However, these electromechanical devices are relatively slow, and they have steps, tabs, so-called steps. This change. And from step tap, one tap to second, another step, goes time close to 10 seconds needed to change one step of this voltage transformation ratio. In many reasons, for example, as I said, stochastic energy production suddenly production, solar production go up and goes down. So in this case, voltage transformer tap cannot work significantly, and moreover, the problems when some interruption in some consumers have some problems and is disconnected from the line, immediately all solar production goes to this line, and voltage is growing very quickly and significantly. So we can see how the tap changer change voltage when there is some voltage rise, voltage swell, and we can see that what steps one after another, tap changer changes this goes into the nominal voltage, and due to the voltage drop, so it takes about 1 minute to return the voltage to the nominal value. And can we see two histograms of voltage, this real measurements during previous year, the entire year of the measurements in the with the resolution of 5 minutes we made one distribution line in the Jordan Valley. Is spread 25 kilometers from substation. Voltage in the substation, this is blue, and near the end consumers, another histograms. And statistics shows that approximately 0.06% of time voltage overcomes maximum, maximum permissible level is 10%, and 0.1% of time is below minimum permissible level. So it seems good, relatively good, but we know that there are a lot of equipment that cannot survive even this deviation. If you take into account that this is 1 year, so this is can be calculated as some tens of minutes during the year when voltage is out of the permissible level, and some kinds of, as I said, some kinds of equipment even could not survive this voltage change. What's to do? And so what's to do? Our clients, we find and present the solution is based on the Planck of capacitive power. We know some another solution, let's say storage system based on ultracapacitor storage batteries, but we found that all these solutions are expensive, require service, big service time. We, as I said, found based our solution on the usage applying of the capacitive power. So outlines analysis of voltage deviations, development equivalent circuit for distribution line distribution station, analytical expression of voltage and current magnitudes after applying capacitive reactive power, and dynamic reaction of capacitor connection to the load. The method of solution. So we represent here the distribution line by equivalent circuit. Here you can see the voltage source for constant voltage source that represents the power station, sub power station, this transformer. Distribution line is represented for one phase, by the way, it's only for one phase, it's enough. Distribution line is represented as reactance and resistance, and load represented by resistance R2 and reactance is 2. And connected to the load, to the connector, to the final load, capacitors XC. And we are searching for the voltage V out, how it's changed. When we assume that V S or voltage source remains constant. Okay, so on the basis of electrical, so equivalent electrical circuit, we develop mathematical analytical expression for the voltage based on the voltage, nodal voltage theorem, and found the expression of the voltage magnification effect depends on, we created this as the, in the dimensionless form of all in the included parameters of this equivalent circuit. And we can see that, let's say immediately for this graph, when capacitance becomes bigger, the magnification effect goes up and achieves its maximum value, relatively big, it can be 2, 3 or more, it's significant magnification effect, and after the continuation of the capacitance grows, so voltage begins drops down. Therefore, the working area of this method, let's say up to the some maximum or some optimal level of capacitance which can be applicable, not more of this. So as I said, it's very, it's on the first step, it was important to know what is this maximum amplification effect is denominated as lambda. And yes, we can see that there is a maximum level, again, depend on some dimensionless parameters of the scheme. And there is a special optimal capacitance value which causes to the maximum magnification amplification effect. here it is, we can see it depends of the as a rule the parameters of the distribution line sinus of Z line, we can see bigger maximum amplification effect. So in this case it is good that there is some reactance of the distribution line, and we can see that in real area which we have in usual distribution lines is from so called this area, and the amplification effect can be close to 2 even more, so it's more than enough for the voltage regulation in distribution. Okay, thank you. So, if you will use the, I intend to use this method, we have to know what is the required capacitance which can be applied, should be applied or should be connected to the load to get the needed amplification effect. So we can, on the basis of previous equation, to develop a mathematical expression, and here we can see the graph with amplification effect, capacitance as the amplification effect. One of the real situation was considered, and so if we will need some value of amplification effect, we can know which capacitance must be connected to the load to get this needed voltage. All good, this method is good. We see that amplification effect, by the way, amplification effect 2 times as much that it's needed. In principle, it's enough to have amplification effect in the range 20% maximum, because it's enough 20-25%. And what's about the count of the distribution line? Here the situation is not so pretty. We have taken this into account, that with the increase of the capacitance, which will be connected to the load, the current related to the nominal current which is produced in the line where capacitance is not connected, this situation shows that current grows significantly, and of course, to get current in the line 3, 4, 5 times bigger than the nominal value is not so applicable. But we can consider that this this method can be applied for 1 minute only, because tap changer continue to work. So to give for tap changer the time to correct the situation, you increase the current rise of the current, let's say up to 2 times, is not so dangerous. We can see here 2 graphs. We applied together with this what the situation will be when the PV production will be introduced in the line on the side of the consumers, and of course it gives us in one side more easier situation with the current. So its relation per unit, it is spoken about the current relation of the current, and when solar production is bigger, so the current increase is lower. The current increase is low. Okay. Okay. So, what's regarding the algorithm and how we can implement this algorithm in automatic control system, which will prevent voltage distribution in distribution lines? Now, firstly, as we saw previously, it is based on the capacitor connection to the load, and for the real specific distribution line and specific loads, we can calculate which maximum capacitance has been applied, especially in the cases which we investigated. This is capacitance maximum up to the 200 microfarads. It's not negligible, but not so big capacitance. It can be found, so this capacitance exist, so we can use them. So we divided maximum capacity which will be, which is needed here to in the binary manner. for example, from our point of view, five steps is enough, and we produce in binary, let's say, minimum capacitance C0 to C0, for C0 up to the, let's say, we have five levels, it can get up to the 16 C0. Each capacitor is connected electronically by, for example, thyristor or triax, it depends on situation, and the algorithm which can evaluate this control system should be as follows. First of all, after starting, permanent voltage measurements, and if the voltage remains in the permissible levels 10% more and less percent and 10% less, so nothing should be done. If it goes over this situation, the next step is to measure the required capacitance value to eliminate voltage instability. On the next step, algorithm or system determines which capacitors should be in this band, should be connected to the load, and this connection is evaluated. Of course, with the connection, with the line which informs tap changer, which is located far away, some kilometers, up to the, say, 30 kilometers, informing the tap changer to improve the situation on the side of the substation. And after this, of course, capacitors will be disconnected. Very important question is here. So state situation seems good, seems applicable. However, we know that connecting, disconnected of reactive of elements, all elements, especially reactive elements as capacitors, calls to the dynamic process, which may be rather complex and may decrease significantly the quality of the electrode. So for this purpose, dynamic process was assessment here on the basis of the Laplace transformation for this same equivalent circuit, and after the transformation we get the transformation the function transformed function and estimated what is the quality or the character of the dynamic process. This is the equation, the differential, original differential equation, third level in the order, and there can be always only negative solution. It's well known. However, it may be situation one negative and two roots, complex roots with conjugated complex parts, and it's not pretty situation because this part calls to the high frequency changes, not so pretty for, so which can decrease significantly the quality of electricity. We analyzed the situation with the plan of the research of determinant of this equation, and found that in all cases that could be easily obtained three negative roots that will provide relatively smooth dynamic process. To verify this situation, these results, we create model, simulation model based on PCM software, and build this the model of the system, which will evaluate the proposed algorithm, control algorithm. And here we see what has happened. Let's say the left side nominal normal situation, and after some period of time, voltage drops to this permissible level. And what has happened? System recognize here we show that it's needed 3 period of times. It's possible to be done in times close to 1 period, so we can we can create the system which react during 1 period of time of the voltage instability. It's very short time, and after this it apply or connect needed capacitors, which is calculated or estimated during this system, so that the voltage is under the permissible level, calculate the needed capacitance value, and connect it to the load. And we see a dot, red lines, what has happened in the voltage. And, brief, the dynamic process relatively applicable smooth. A little bit more complicated the current, but in principle this too can be applicable in the system. So only in the case when we have to form, let's say, to tune the protecting system, not to react on this current, small current deviation. Okay, so now results and conclusion. As we see that the introduction of solar, especially PV stations, which have no inertia, so they react immediately, let's say immediately after solar radiation, which can be changed quickly. The efficient solution can be based on application of capacitive reactive power to the load by the switching by the switching of capacitors, needed capacitors, to the load. The bank of the set of capacitors, let's say bank of capacitors, should be created in the binary manner, which we say, and if we will take 5 levels, it's enough to create the accuracy close to 3% of the voltage control. Substantial, it's this control is escorted by significant current increase, and it should be considered. However, the situation can be improved if we apply this system, okay, not to prevent the usage of the tap changer, which must be informed of the situation with the capacitors connection to the load. Dynamic process of voltage distortion when capacitor being connected can be smoothed significantly. I forgot to say that the situation can be improved even with the current when we connect capacitor.